What's going on, Legends? Welcome back to another Apex video. Today we're going to be talking about more lore in Apex Legends and theory crafting about why the Legends in the game don't actually die when they go down in the Battle Royale. Let's get to the video now. In Apex Legends, one of the biggest mysteries in this game is why the Legends don't die. What happens to the Legends that allows them to respawn and come back into the game? In most Battle Royales, this isn't something that you would think about, but because of the lore that surrounds and binds itself with this game, I believe there is a reason that this happens that has not been revealed yet. There are many theories that I've seen floating around, such as Legends aren't actually trying to kill each other, or that they're doing it in a virtual simulation where they aren't actually physically in the arena doing the fighting. However, I believe there's a much darker reason behind this. What if I told you that all the Legends are simulacrum? Before you click off, there are quite a few hints and teasers that could lead to this theory being true, even one involving the new Legend introduced in Season 6 of the game. The first time I started thinking that this could possibly be true was in Season 5 when they introduced Loba. We see Loba enter a bunker underneath King's Canyon in which there are hundreds, if not thousands, of empty shelled remnants lying await underneath King's Canyon. How did this get here? That was the first question I had. How did a facility of this size with revenant bodies get under King's Canyon? Something like this had to have been placed long before the Apex games even started. That is when I started looking into other trailers and voice lines within the game to see if anything else popped out that might be able to connect to this. The first thing that I looked into was one of Crypto's finishers. In one of the finishers, Crypto takes a chip from the Legends. Why, if they are human, besides from Pathfinder and Revenant, is Crypto able to pull out a thumb drive out of every single one of the Legends? This doesn't seem to add up. If they were humanoid, this is not something that he would be able to do. Caustic also has a death certificate. Caustic, when introduced, is showed in a video that he has a death certificate and explains that there were fingers blown off around a lab that match Caustic's DNA with the fingers that they found in the explosion. If this had been something to completely throw people off, would Caustic be missing some fingers? It also mentions the body was burned unrecognizably. Again, even if this was a body double, he would have at least still been missing some fingers because he had to match the DNA to the lab. Caustic also has a cough that, for me, for those Star Wars fans out there, seems very much like General Grievous, which makes me think that he is an android or a simulacrum. We can also look at the last three Legends that were introduced, and every single event, there was a possibility for one of them to die. Loba falls into the pit and the screen blacks out. She then throws her ring back up and every single one of the Legends is located where Skulltown went down. Wouldn't it take some time for them to traverse the map to get there? If this event was instant, you would think that you would see some there and then some in the distance that were running crazily trying to figure out what the heck happened in King's Canyon, but that's not the case. Every single one of the Legends is located where Loba comes up. The next one is very obvious with Revenant. He's obviously already a simulacrum, but a good example shown here is that minds can be altered, maybe even to the point where they see other Legends in the game as their former selves and not their robot selves. And then with the newest introduced Legend, Rampart, Rampart gets hit in the back of the head and blacks out. There's a moment in the trailer where she gets attacked and she blacks out. When she comes back to, Bliss walks up to her and invites her to the Apex games. This is when she was collected and turned into one herself. Why is she friends with Bangalore's simulacrum? What if the whole time she knew Bangalore, she has been a simulacrum herself? So to her, it wasn't weird to befriend a machine, especially when she enjoys working on weapons. Most of the Legends in this game have an event that you can tie back to their story that they could have died from and been turned into a simulacrum. This does not apply to every single Legend at the time of this filming, but I believe before everything is said and done with the Tales of the Outlaw stories that we are getting, this will be introduced. Another huge connection that I found interesting is that every single one of the Legends have a simulacrum skin. This I found interesting because it's something that really tied into my theory that they are all a form of simulacrum. This change, while a cosmetic one in-game, could have more of a lore reason behind it than we think. Why would they all have an android skin? This, on top of the other items I've discussed, has led me to believe this is a potential outcome that we will discover later on in the game's lore. I don't know about you, but there seems to be a lot of evidence from officially released media that leads to this theory, in my opinion, to be something that can be very real for us as we get further into seasons of the game. It makes you wonder, are there many other bunkers under World's Edge in King's Canyon that hold the simulacrum bodies of our legends? What does that mean for our legends who have been working each individually at a goal that they believe is rightfully their own and not a program goal? It's possible that what Cuban Blisk is doing is finding warriors that have been severely injured in the line of duty or because of accidents like Octane's, where he blew his legs off, and then turning them into simulacrum unknowingly. And this is why they come back and they keep on fighting. They do not know that this is happening though, and to them, they believe in themselves that they are still human and part of the human society. How much of a shakeup would it be if this ended up being true, and Cuban Blisk is profiting off of all the legends because he has them in this false reality in which they believe they are working to get out of on their own free will, but are actually, tragically, under the complete control of Cuban Blisk and the IMC. What do you think of this theory? Would you like this to be the case in the game? Do you think this could explain why we never die and we're able to respawn? I'm interested to hear what you have to say below. If you like this video and you want to continue to see more videos on Apex lore, make sure to smash that like button and hit subscribe so we can stay up to date with all the content that I put out weekly. Also, you can catch me streaming on Twitch Monday, Thursday, Friday at 7 p.m. Pacific time at tfipsy.tv. Come swing by, say hi. Would love to talk more Apex lore with you. I also have a growing Discord that I'd love you to join. We talk a lot about Apex Legends in there. Come swing by, say hi. Would be a great way to stay connected 24/7. And with that, we'll catch you in the next drop in Legends. Have a good one. No! No, 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 no.
Go, Bamboozle.
Thank you for the bits, my friend. No, 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 no. Oh my gosh. What the hell, dude? Bro! What? What in the flying dude? Go Bamboozle! To the no, 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 yeah, to the no, yeah, to the no. Absolute disrespect right there, dude. This guy's just sparted you. I know. It's Fall Guys crossplay. It is not crossplay, so it is.